Hello, and welcome to PECOS. In this demonstration, we're going to show you how to log into PECOS and reactivate one of your Medicare enrollments. In this example, we'll be performing the reactivation on an application for a durable medical equipment supplier. But the screens and steps are very much the same even if you're performing a reactivation for an organization of any type or for an individual. So to start, we're going to have to log in. So go ahead and pull up the login credentials you received when you first submitted your Medicare application. If you have any questions about your login credentials or need further support, go ahead and click on the Forgot Password link shown here or the Manage/Update User Profile link shown below it. So I'm going to go ahead and log in.
Entering user ID.
After logging in, the first screen you'll see is this PECOS homepage. So you'll select the My Enrollments button here to begin the reactivation. And then you'll need to select whichever organization you need to perform the reactivation for. So as an end user here, you'll see all of the organizations you have access to down below. And since we are performing this reactivation today with the organization called Medical Equipment Suppliers, I'll select the View Enrollments button here. You'll then be navigated to this page. We'll want to scroll down to the bottom of the screen to select the specific enrollment application you aim to reactivate. So here, this one is shown as a voluntarily withdrawn application, and this is the one I want to reactivate. So I'll select the More Options button shown here. On this screen, you'll confirm that you wish to reactivate the enrollment, so you'll select this option and select the Next Page button to continue. You'll then be navigated to a confirmation screen where you can confirm that the reason for your application shown here is accurate for your situation. So because we are reactivating, this is correct. And so we'll scroll down to the bottom of the page and select the Start Application button to begin this reactivation. You'll next be pulled into your enrollment application here. And if you scroll down on the page, you'll see there are a number of sections that need to be completed here, shown without check marks, before you'll be able to scroll down to the bottom of the page and click on this Begin Submission button shown here. These sections that need to be completed before you submit your reactivation can be done in any order. So for the purpose of this demonstration, I'll start with the DME Hours of Operation and Jurisdictions Covered section and walk you through that first. Add information to this section, you'll click on the Add Information button shown here. You'll then be prompted to indicate the opening and closing times of your business. So for this example, I'll select that the business opens at 8 a.m. and closes at 5 p.m. Monday through Friday. After indicating your selection for opening and closing times and days of the week, you'll just select the Next Page button at the bottom of the screen. You'll then need to indicate the hours of operation that are available to the public. So in this example, I'll enter 40 and move forward by selecting the Next Page button. As a durable medical equipment supplier, you'll then need to indicate the DME state where services or items are provided. So in this example, we'll select Florida and move forward by selecting the Save button at the bottom of the screen. Note that services can be provided in more than one state, so you can add more states by simply selecting this Add More button shown here. After adding all of this information, you'll be navigated to the Topic Summary screen here, where you'll see all of the information added as labels, and you can edit this information, add more states where services are rendered, or delete any of the information as well using the button shown on the screen. Now that this section is complete, we'll navigate back to the main view of this reactivation submission. And you'll see that this section has a check mark next to it indicating that it's been completed. So for the purpose of this demonstration, now that we've completed our first section that needs to be done before reactivating our enrollment, I'm going to go ahead and complete the rest of the information for the remaining missing sections in order to show you the submission process at the end for this reactivation.
Cursor clicks on selected physical location and special payments address.
So now I've gone ahead and entered information for almost all of the sections that were missing information. And before you can scroll down to the bottom of that screen and select the Begin Submission button, there's still one more section that needs to be addressed, which is this Required and or Supporting Documentation section. And if you scroll to the top of the screen here, you'll note that there's one error that still needs to be addressed on our application before we can submit it. So we'll select this Error/Warning Check tab, and you'll see that that error is regarding this Required and or Supporting Documentation section. So we need to indicate whether or not any required documents will be uploaded electronically with our submission. So I'll select this topic by selecting this hyperlink here, and I'll indicate that no, I do not wish to upload any supporting documents. Note that for any scenario where you do have documentation that you'd like to electronically upload, just select yes to this question and you'll be prompted to attach those documents in this section here. So after selecting this answer, I'm going to hit the Return to Topics button at the bottom of the screen. And you'll see now that we have no errors or warnings left on this application and that every single section on this page is now complete and we're ready to go. So we're going to scroll down and hit this Begin Submission button at the bottom of the screen now. The first page that is pulled up when beginning your submission is an electronic signatures page where you're prompted to indicate whether or not you'd like to electronically sign any supporting documentation for your application. In this case, it's a certification statement. So I'm going to select yes that I'd like to electronically sign this document, which means that I won't have to print out and mail a hard copy of this document to my Medicare administrative contractor. So I'll select yes here and click on the next page button to move forward. You'll then be brought to a Signatory for Organization Enrollment page where you'll need to go to this dropdown here and select an authorized signer to electronically sign this submission for your application. So in this case, John Smith is an authorized official, so we'll select him as the authorized signer, select the Apply button, and then enter the email address for John Smith. What will happen is he will receive an email prompting him to electronically sign this submission, and after he has electronically signed this submission, your Medicare administrative contractor will be able to begin processing the reactivation. You'll then be brought to the submission page here, where your Medicare administrative contractor is shown here as a label. Your reason for submission is shown as well, so you should confirm that, and then additional information on required and supporting documents is shown here as well. If you scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page, you'll see the Complete Submission button here and the Previous Page button as well if you need to make any corrections to your application or you're concerned that the data in it needs to be updated or reviewed one final time before you submit your reactivation to your contractor. So because I'm ready to submit this, I'm going to select the Complete Submission button here. A pop-up will then appear on your screen to notify you that any required and supporting documentation that you have not electronically uploaded to your application will need to be mailed in to your Medicare administrative contractor. And if you do not do this, your submission will risk being delayed in processing. So once you've acknowledged this fact, you can click on the OK button, and you'll be navigated to the submission confirmation page where you can print this as a receipt for your personal records. Congratulations, you've just completed a reactivation of your Medicare enrollment in PECOS.